always knew that architecture would be his life. Pretty long with me, actually. But he might not have known that one of his brilliant designs would be constructed in his own backyard. Our city is truly fortunate to be able to boast one of his prestigious works here in our capital city. All of you know, along with people like Robert Venturi and Philip Johnson, Michael Graves is on the very shortest list of preeminent American architects in the second half of this century. Just as all of us recognize that, his own profession has recognized it by conferring on him 15 Progressive Architecture Awards, 9 National Honor Awards by the AIA, and more than 50 awards by the New Jersey Society of Architects of the AIA. Michael Graves has won the Indiana Arts Award, New Jersey's Walt Whitman Award, a citation for career achievement from the Chicago Athenaeum, and honorary degrees from some 7 universities. All of this occurs, of course, because of the some 200 designs which are the hallmark of his career. Designs at places like the Whitney Museum and Sotheby's Tower in New York, like the Humana Building nearby in Louisville, like architecture in institutions such as the University of Virginia in Emory, and at the Disney Complex in Florida, and indeed at Euro Disney, and at the Vatican, and yes, in Japan and in Asia, in places like the Taipei Museum, and of course, here in Indianapolis, at those remarkable interior spaces, the noteworthy exterior of the Thompson Consumer Electronics Center. Governor Evan Bayh has asked me to come and make Michael Graves a part of the history of our state. All of you know that over these last several generations, governors have conferred on the most distinguished Americans the designation of Sagamore of the Wabash. I asked Governor Bayh why he thought I was the one who ought to come in his stead. And he said he knew that I had started out as an architecture student at Princeton when Michael Graves was a young associate professor. Couldn't hack at that, and so had to become a lawyer. And that seemed a suitable qualification. In any event, in the Native American tribes of the Northeastern United States, a sagamore is a wise and brave man for whom the chiefs of the tribe would look for advice and counsel on the most important of things. And so over recent generations, Indiana governors have designated great and wise Hoosiers to join the Council of Sagamores of the Wabash. It is the highest honor that a governor of Indiana can confer. It is my pleasure, therefore, confer upon Michael Graves, on behalf of Governor Bayh, the designation of Sagamore of the Wabash. I might say that as Governor Orr was fond of saying, it's far better than being a Kentucky Colonel. There are no meetings and no dues.
That's like a Mike McCune prank.
It's in a Biedermeier frame as well, in my favorite. I'm really bowled over by all of this. What I find quite amazing is that, well, first of all, I'm staying downtown in a hotel that has about 12 people in it, and most of downtown has about 14. And there are more people here tonight than in all of Princeton and most of New Jersey. I thought when Joyce said, come in your tux, she and I were going into Broad Ripple to go to some funky restaurant. And there'd be about a dozen of us, our table and a couple of other people that would sort of raise our glasses and toast this incredible lady. But 700 and some people, this is quite amazing. Somebody mentioned Whitney Museum a minute ago, and I want to tell you that with the budget of this building and what Joyce and all of you were able to raise was about $7 million more than the Whitney Museum raised for very good. So before another sagamore, Reggie, decides to go east, he should consider staying right here. About the best thing that happened to me tonight was, as I was walking through the building, somebody came up to me and said, you don't know me, but, and I listened and she said, I work here every day and I can't tell you what a joy it is to come to work. I mean, that's the best thing an architect can hear. But you can't hear that kind of thing without people like we have on this job, and I'm thinking just of the construction. Shiv Saxon have done an incredible job. And the two people that work for them, that are them in this building, we call the two Daves, are people that have made the difference in making this building better than others, so they are extraordinary. And then from my office, Adina Shakay, who last time we opened the first half, I asked to come and say something, and I promised her I wouldn't do that tonight. But Adina is here tonight, and she's the one that worries through every detail of the building, and I get to sit there in my office in Princeton and just say yes or no. And if it's really serious, I'll call Joyce. But Adina is the one that followed this project all the way through, and to the point where Joyce put her up, and she was here simply to save money. So I thank you both for that. In terms of the building, very quickly, it's very hard for an architect who also likes to paint, but I'm not a painter, I'm an architect, to make a place for people to work doing what you as artists do, because you don't want to get in their way. It's a bit like doing a museum, but museum design in America has gone to a kind of neutrality that I'm not quite in favor of, but that we're not in favor of. But in this building, what we wanted to do was give the best light we could for each of the studios to make places where people could really prosper and do what they should do to both make and wonderful things and fail at wonderful things, but to do it in the best setting that we could provide for them. And yes, neutrality was a part of it, simply not to get in their way and to let them do their art. And finally, the person who was honored a few minutes ago, Joyce, is somebody who I barely knew in high school, but have known these last few years in a way that is enormously rewarding for me. First of all, when she called and asked me to do this building, I thought she was a bit wacko, and that it probably wouldn't happen, and yes, we would give it a good try, and so on, but I couldn't say no because it's home, and it's rare that you get to work at home. It's too rare to get to work with him. That's another conversation. Could I trade this in on but then to raise all this money to provide this tent, forget the building, I mean this tent. I think of other institutions in New York and thereabouts that could possibly do this. I mean, the food, the place, there are people on walkie-talkies doing things that none of us know about. I think they're going to be elected. I don't know. But the great thing about Joyce and all of you that provided this place for us to get to have fun doing, and that was really what it was, is that she's still wacko. And thank goodness for that. The artists whose creations